Welcome to SystemVue. In this demonstration, we'll look at five new features in SystemVue 2011 that apply Spectrasys to modern RFIC transceiver architectures. In this video, you'll see primarily the W1719 RF System Design Kit. Of the demonstrations we'll do today, the very first that will be of interest is that Spectrasys now allows multiple I/O ports in the RF link. This is useful for MIMO, for diversity, for separate IMQ and Cartesian architectures, as well as multi-band front ends. Let's take a look at that. In this example, we've got an RF modulated carrier that comes in and is split into separate IMQ paths with a common LO. That down converter is attached to an RF preamp and a preselect filter, and that overall three-port receiver architecture is this RF link circuit. We drag and drop it out of the workspace tree, and you can see that it automatically instantiates with the correct number of ports. Since these are baseband INQ outputs, that brings up benefit number two. Namely, that DC is now a valid carrier frequency for Spectrasys. The RF link capability allows baseband inputs and outputs. This allows you to look at architectures with direct conversion and zero IF and produce baseband INQ outputs like we're doing here. In our system, we have a baseband QPSK transmitter that's upconverted, sent through our Spectrasys network, which has an RF front end and a down converter to this baseband INQ output, which goes through some A to D converters and then finally to a QPSK receiver that we've set up. Let's tune the LO isolation on these two mixers and watch what happens. First, let's simulate, get a nominal result. The red trace is the oversampled trace coming out of the transmit. The blue trace is the decimated result in baseband. Let's turn on the tune window and tune the isolation to 10 dB from 30. We see that the DC offset of the self-mixing term of the LO feed-through term has created a DC offset in the baseband. I can also add some gain imbalance and some phase balance of a few degrees and watch the impairments accumulate. That brings up the next improvement in Spectrasys, and that the Spectrasys phase noise impairments now propagate up to the system level in RF link. Spectrasys allows correlated and multiplied noise sources, so when you have a local oscillator that is also multiplied up, the phase noise of those two sources, the original and the multiplied version, are in fact correlated. You can have close into carrier, and Spectrasys does maintain individual contributors so that you can diagnose these, the individual contributions later. The total result is passed up to the data flow level. To see this, I'll double-click on the RF link component and say calculate phase noise and resimulate. Now, let me reduce some of that LO impairment. And enable the VSA software. So now let's demodulate this with a real VSA. Here I'm looking at the constellation, the spectrum, and the error vector magnitude across the spectrum, and you can see that most of the distortion is in band. If I stop the simulation and change this isolation to a slightly degraded value and resimulate, I see that my LO feed-through term is showing up at DC as a DC spike, and now my equalizer in the VSA is having trouble locking onto the signal. We'll stop this simulation and turn on the A to D converters. So now we'll get a level of quantization error to these simulations and simulate again. And you can see the effect of the A to D converters having brought up the noise floor and further degraded the error vector magnitude. The summary of this is that Spectrasys which used to be more of a scalar tool, is now useful for vector architectures at the system level. The fourth improvement is a Volterra modeling step that adds speed and memory improvements to Spectrasys for nonlinear components, especially those in a multi-tone, multi-carrier situation, such as this noise power ratio measurement. The Volterra surface creates a behavioral model that is faster, allows denser spectrums, and allows more accurate treatment of these multi-carrier situations for single-tone X parameters. In this example, we have a single X parameter device that's been exported from ADS, so we know the true result of this X parameter device. It's been put in an RF link in a two-tone case and in a 10-tone case. This has been done two different ways: two tones within Spectrasys and only using Spectrasys, and two tones created in data flow and passed into the system level through an RF link of this and analyzed at the system level. That's this result. You can see that the distortion terms are exactly the same between the two cases. For a 10-tone case, a noise power ratio, we look at the depth of the notch, and in this case, the native Spectrasys result is equivalent to the data flow result, where 10 individual carriers are sent through an RF link component and measured on the output. Since these results are virtually identical, let's increase the power 10 dB and watch what happens. Okay, you can see that the notch has degraded. We raised the power 10 dB. You can see that the notch has degraded about 20 dB, and it's still within 2 dB agreement between the two-tone and the 10-tone cases. To use this new feature, simply open up the circuit link and click on Fast Volterra Simulation. The fact that we were using X parameters leads to the fifth new feature, and that is that Spectrasys, as an RF architecture tool, now has direct design links to RF design flows to ADS and to GoldenGate. ADS can export an X parameter model, or in GoldenGate, you can now export a fast circuit envelope model. These models are enabled with the W1719 RF System Design Kit license. They offer friendly drag and drop simplicity of ease of use, as well as over 1,000 times faster simulation performance over direct coast simulation because they run natively in representations within the SystemVue environment. This speed allows high-level system performance, such as bit error rate and throughput measurements, to be made. For the case where behavioral models don't capture the true behavior because the behavior is dynamic because of self-heating or loops, or you need ultimate accuracy, direct co-simulations are now possible with both ADS and GoldenGate directly from SystemVue. This allows you to verify the things that you've architected early and use your original RF architectures as the basis for the verifications later on. To summarize, there were five things that Spectrasys has added that will be of interest to modern transceiver designers. We've been through multiple I/O ports, DC, phase noise, Volterra modeling, and links to GoldenGate and ADS. By the way, if you're an RF system architect, you may want to look at the A to D converter model at the data flow level. There's a new A to D model in SystemVue that allows you to specify performance directly. Instead of integral nonlinear error, you can now specify things that you really want to measure about your circuit, such as spur-free dynamic range, SINAD, effective number of bits, harmonics in DBC, and frequency domain jitter. Here in this A to D converter, we've specified the distortion model as being the harmonic levels directly in dB as an input. If I change the number of bits, you can watch the distortion terms come out of the noise floor as the noise floor settles with more bits. And those come directly out of this specification. So instead of measuring these things, you can use them as parameters on the A to D converter itself. I hope these demonstrations have been helpful to you in RF system architecture and system design. If you'd like to see more videos, see www.agilent.com, find esoft-systemview-videos. Good luck in your next system design.